And as we are taught in the passage, gifts of the Holy Spirit, which are found in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, and there's the gifts of Jesus Christ. Let's take a look at Ephesians chapter 4. And he himself, okay, right in verse 7, but to each one us grace was given according to the measure of Christ's gift. Therefore he says, when he ascended on high, he led the captives and gave gifts to men. Now, this he ascended, what does it mean? But that he also first descended into the lower parts of the earth, referring to the earth, you can go as far as to say Hades. He who descended also, the one who ascended far above all the heavens, that he might fill all things, And he himself gave some to be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors, some teachers, for equipping the saints for the work of ministry, for edifying the body of Christ. Now, apostles and prophets no longer needed, because their function and purpose was to bring forth this word. And so that only leaves us with pastors, which are bishops and elders. And from the Bible, from the original language, the Bible communicates that the bishop, the elder, and pastor are the same. Teachers being deacons. Well, and I forgot evangelists, who are those who go out and preach the gospel of truth. And teachers, deacons. In the Old Testament, prophets ordained, and the king with anointing oil. But since there's no need for apostles and prophets, since they fulfilled their function, the prophet is now those who teach and preach, those who preachers today are, in a sense, prophets who preach and teach prophecy, which is the word of God. And so therefore they can anoint and ordain the leadership, deacons, evangelists, etc. They can also ordain people with titles of nobility, such as Duke, Archduke, and so forth. They have the ecclesiastical perspective, and pastors being bishops and archbishops, because there's head bishops and there's bishops, which are also grand dukes and archdukes. Or I'm sorry, archdukes and dukes. Evangelists being knights, in a sense, deacons being such as Marcus, Count, Vice Count, Baron. Memberships. Membership, the elect. The elect. Baronets. And of course, in the Old Testament, king ordained people to various positions of government in the Old Testament. You read about the qualifications of a bishop in 1 Timothy chapter 3, verses 1 through 7. We read about the qualifications of a deacon in 1 Timothy chapter 3, 8 through 13. Acts 14:23, and the apostles meant for the bishops to carry on after them. Acts 14:23, we read, so when they appointed elders in every church and prayed with fasting, they commanded that the Lord in whom they believed. Titus 1:5. Qualifications of elders, which are the same as bishops and because the Apostle Paul is writing to Timothy, elder is simply esteem of respect. Hebrews 13 is important. Obey those who rule over you and be submissive, for they watch out for your souls as those who must give account. Let them do so with joy and not with grief, or that would be unprofitable for you. This is rulers. Those who rule over us refers to not only sacred authorities, but the governmental authority of the church. Because in the, you might say, vision of God, there is no distinction between civil and ecclesiastical authority. But in the secular world, they wish to separate those two. But in God's mind, there is no distinction or separation between those two. And so, 1 Corinthians 15, 24 and following. Then comes the end when he delivers the kingdom of God to the Father when he puts an end to all rule and authority and power, for he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. Once Christ resurrected, he sat down, and the church is his earthly feet to make the enemies Jesus' footstool for his feet. So the Bible clearly communicates delegated authority. Children must obey their parents. Ephesians chapter 6, 1 through 4. Bond servants must obey their master. In the sense, the biblical sense, what this means is that your boss at work is in charge, and the bondservant is employee who must obey their employer, the bondservant being the employee and the master. In this passage of scripture, referring to the employer, Ephesians chapter 6, 5 through 8. The Bible communicates delegated authority. Also, husband and wife relationship as well. Ephesians chapter 5, verses 22 to 33. And of course, in some of my other sermons, I've already discussed the husband and wife type of relationship. God's kingdom is a constitutional monarch. And the great thing about it, it doesn't conflict, is not in conflict with other forms of government. Because it's spiritual and eternal kingdom, but it also has a spiritual eternal kingdom, and in that spiritual eternal kingdom, there is an ecclesiastical and civil aspect of it. And so there you have it, biblical divine rights of kings. And then the next sermon we'll be looking at sovereignty.